Welcome to Wendt Study. My name is Randy Wendt, and today is November 14th, 2009. I'd like to take a moment or two to focus on two passages of Scripture that talk about the role of the Holy Spirit in our lives. First, from 2 Corinthians 3, verse 18. But we all, with unveiled face, beholding as in a mirror the glory of the Lord, are being transformed into the same image from glory to glory, just as by the Spirit of the Lord. And then from Galatians 4:19, just this latter fragment of the verse, until Christ is formed in you. Both of these passages talk about a formation process, of being transformed, being more like Christ, or Christ being completely formed in us. And we know this to be the role of the Holy Spirit. We know this to be the work of sanctification, to make us more Christ-like, to make us more holy, to make us more connected to Christ. But how does this come about? Well, it doesn't come about by our doing. It doesn't come about by our activity. It doesn't come about by our will or our desire necessarily, but it's all God acting upon us. We hear references to being vessels, clay jars. We hear references in the Bible to God being the potter and we being the clay, and even how he formed Adam from the dust of the ground. God has always been in the creating process, the forming process. And so we as Christians who come to faith by means of the Holy Spirit who creates that faith in us, we are then being formed to be more like Christ. As this verse says in Second Corinthians 3:18, being transformed. So we leave behind what we were so that we can become what Christ would have us be. And again, not by our actions, but rather by the Holy Spirit acting upon us. Look into your life this week. See if there are areas where you need to be formed, where you need to be transformed, where you need to have Christ formed in you. And commit those areas of your life to the Lord. Perhaps it might be to have a more faithful prayer life, to spend more time in prayer, to pray on behalf of others. Then this would be something that you would want to commit to the Lord and ask for his help or guidance. Perhaps it might be sharing your faith. Perhaps you're hesitant about that, or you're fearful of it, or you may say, well, I don't know what to say when someone has a question. But yet it's the Holy Spirit who speaks through us. It's the Holy Spirit's words that are powerful. And so again, we're only the vessel, we're only the jar, we're only the means by which God would communicate his word to the lost. So thank you for stopping by, and we pray God's blessings to you as you walk your Christian walk, and as God gives you opportunity to talk your Christian talk with those lost who need to hear it. Thank you, and God bless your day.